Good day, students. Welcome to a new session of IT 402 subject. As you all know, we have already completed the entire syllabus for your board exams, and now I'm going to give you some revision lessons on the most important parts of the syllabus. So today we are going to do a complete revision of Unit 3, that is RDBMS. And this revision is basically more from the point of view of a practical exam. In case there is a practical exam which is going to be conducted later on, then this particular session will be very useful to you, because we are going to ask you from the RDBMS unit whatever is covered in today's video, only that much will be asked from the practical point of view. It is also a revision of the entire unit, so you will be able to understand the important parts of this particular unit. So let us go on into the revision of this particular RDBMS unit. Let us first revise the concepts of the database management system, that is the Unit 3, the first few sessions, which gives you a preview of the database system. So here we have got what is a database, what you know, what is a database management system. It is used for creation, maintenance and the use of a database. And what are the examples of a database? That is, you have got Oracle, Access, MS SQL, Fox Pro, SQLite. All these are examples. We also know that there are two types of databases, flat file and relational. In a flat file database, all the data is stored in a single table and it's useful for less amount of data. Relational database stores data in multiple tables which are linked to each other using a common field, and it is useful for large amount of data. So these are the two basic types of databases. Then we know that all the data which is kept in is all the important data or databases are generally stored on one big important machine which is called as a database server, from where all the other database the other machines can access it. So this is called as a front end and a back end. So the front end database server and the back end, the front end is the tools which the people use, and the back end is the actual server where the entire data is saved. So this is called as the database server. Such databases are referred to are based on the client server model of networking. Now here we have got the advantages of why we are using advantages, because it reduces data redundancy, and when the data is stored on a single database server, then you can share the data. There is data integrity, there is data security, and there is privacy of data. So and there is backup and recovery is possible, data consistency is possible. So these are some of the advantages of using a database. Then we have to look at what are the features of a database, what exactly a database contains. So it contains tables, fields, records, and each record contains different values. So this is what are the different features of the database. You can just go through the features of database and read it. The important feature is data record uniqueness, which is important here. In every table, there should be every record has got unique data, and it is important to be able to distinguish between duplicate values. This is one of the important features of data uniqueness. So here they have given you a few examples of what a database or a table looks like with rows, columns and values and fields. So here you have got roll number, name, standard section. These are the fields and these are the records, and each of this individual is a value. That is 19, RAM, 10th, A, all these are values. So this is the basic concept. Now here they are giving you an examples of RDBMS. RDBMS, as I told you, when there are multiple records and lots of records and multiple tables in which data is stored, then that becomes a relational database system. So here they have given you an example of a relational database table where there are multiple tables, and here they are explained the concept of a primary key, composite key and foreign key. Now what is a primary key? A primary key is a key or is a field which stores unique value that identifies a particular row. For example, client ID, roll number, SID number, item number. These are unique for every record and it cannot be repeated. No two people will be having the same SID number in school, or no two people will have the same Aadhaar card number, or no two clients will have the same client ID. So that particular field is called as a primary key. Now when this primary key constraint is applied to one or more fields, then it becomes a composite primary key. So there may be a table where you may be having two fields which are primary key. So then that one becomes a composite primary key. Then what is a foreign key? When there are multiple tables and when one of the fields of a particular, for example, client ID is used in a sales table, but then in the sales table, the sales ID is the primary key, and that time the client ID will become the foreign key because the client ID is a primary key of another table. So this is called as a foreign key. So the field reference client ID which occurs in the sales table is called as a primary key, because in such a case the sales table may be having another primary key, which is the here. So your example is also very clearly mentioned over here. Here we have got client ID, which is the primary key of this particular client table, and here we have the sales table where order ID is the primary key and client ID is also used in this. So this becomes the foreign key in this particular table. So this is the concept of a primary key, composite key and foreign key. Now here we have got RDBMS. This is what is explained in the first sessions. Next one, we go to the second session whereby we explained the different objects which are there in the database, that is tables, what is a column, what is a field, what is a row, a record, a tuple, etc. So a record is a single record, is called as a tuple, which has got which gives you the entire details of the record, that is called the different fields. All the entries are constituted into one single row, and that is called as a record. Now the next part is how to create a database and how to create a table inside the database and how to enter records in this particular table. So this is the example, or this is the particular question which I had asked you in your practice test. So let us use this only example. I'm going to show all the how to create this database, how to enter the data, all this using the same example further on. So now here we are going to learn how to create this particular table called Fabric in a database, how to enter these records, and later on how we are going to use the SQL commands to solve this particular question which was asked in your exam. So now first we go on to creating a database table. I will open the software Apache OpenOffice, and here we are going to now do database. So we will double click and open database. It will ask you a wizard, database wizard. You said create a new database, open an existing database file, or connect to any other existing database structure. So here if we had already created a database, we can just simply click on this, and here we had created St. Mary's new database, a few of them we are done. So this, or else let us start with the scratch, that is we are going to create a new, completely new database, and inside that database we are going to learn how to create a table. So I click on the next option, and here there is nothing much to do over here. Open the database for editing, that is the only thing you need to be, it needs to be checked. Now click on finish. Now here you will need to give a data name to this database. So on the desktop I'm saving it, so I'm going to give a name to it. Let's take SR Clothing. So that is the name of my database, SR Clothings. That is the name I'm giving to this database. So it is a ODF database file, and I click on the save button. Now here it will open up the database for me, that is SR Clothing database, SR Clothing ODB file will be open for me. Now here we have got the four different things. Here we are going to create a table. Now we are going to create a table using the design view. So I will double click. But before that, let me go back here and see the structure. So here I have to create fabric ID, fabric name, type and quality. So here I will create the table with the fields. So first, my first field is fabric ID. I can do in capital or small, whichever I want to. Let me keep it as everything as small letter. Fabric ID, which is wear care. Now when I click on this, down below you have got the field properties, entry required, yes you need it. What is the length? Let us take, I want to keep the length as only 6. Then, and this next one will be fabric name or F name, again wear care. I want to keep the length as only 20. Entry is required, yes. Next one is item that again wear care, and I want to keep it as 30. And here we are going to have the quantity, which is I can keep it as an integer type, where it is not an automatic value. Entry is required, yes, and let's take the length is as only 10. Now here, this way, here I'm going to give the fabric ID as my primary key. So how to set the primary key? Click on this right hand side with the right mouse button and click on primary key. So my fabric ID will become the primary key. Now I have to save this table. The name of the table is fabric, and say OK. Now my table with the four fields has got saved. Now I will go back here. My fabric table has got saved with other the structure of the table. I will double click and start entering my records in it one by one. So my first record F 001, fabric name cotton, the item that is created is shirts, and quantity let's take 20. So here we have seen how to create a table in the design view, and what are the field names, how to give the data types and the length. Now here, this is the exact explanation of what I have already explained to you, how to save a file and how to set a primary key for that particular field. Now here, the next is important one which we need to revise is about the different data types. So the field names, along with that we also mentioned data types. So there are a few different types of data types which define the type of data which is going to be stored in the fields. So there are numeric type of data, alphanumeric, binary, date and time, and other variable options. So the numeric type of data, here the options are given. That means when you want to store purely numeric type, roll number, name, or the door number, year of the school admission, date, all this you can. So here there are the different types, that is boolean, small int, a tiny int, integer, big int, numeric, decimal, etc., and the description of this which is given over here. You just have to go through and understand the different numeric data types. Then there are alphanumeric, which is long char, where the total number of the length of the characters which are stored is quite a large one. Then there is character type, where it is in extra small size of characters, or the normal var char text, which has stores up to a specific length, no padding is required. All this type of data are the numeric data type, the alphanumeric data types. In alphanumeric data type, you can store both alphabets, numbers, and special characters. So you want to give an address, or you want to give the name of a person, or some description which has got numbers and special characters, you can choose the var char data type. Now here, the binary data type, it is used to store exact only yes or no, or images and binary numbers. That is used, the binary data type can be used for storing that type of data. Photographs, music style, music, pictures, etc. can be used in, when you want to store that, then you need to use it as a binary data type. And then the date and time, which is used for like admission date, date of birth, or product date, sale date, etc. You can use the date and time data type. So basically these are the different data types which we can use in our database table and select the field names. So that is what is the description given over here in this. The next one, important one, is here again they have showed us how to edit a record and how to delete a record from a table, and how to insert a field, and what are field properties, which I've already told you what are the field properties. That is the length, default value. Now suppose if you want to keep a default value, then default value means that particular field will have that only value. You will not be able to change that value. For example, if you are taking class and division and you don't want to change the class and division, and you want to keep it only as 10th A, 10th B, so you can put the default value over there in the field property. So these are the four different types of field properties, that is required, auto field, all this, length, required, default value, and some format examples are also there which you can select from the field properties. Now here the next one is sorting of data, which I will show you later on. Then they have spoken about referential integrity, which I had already explained to you why it is needed when there are two or multiple tables, then why you need to have referential integrity in them so as to maintain the consistency of the data in the different tables, so that when you insert a new record, then that corresponding record should be there in the new tables, or if you want to delete a record from one table, then that particular related record in the other table also needs to be deleted or updated. And that is why when you are creating relationships between tables, then it causes something called as referential integrity. Please go through the videos which I had already earlier posted, and where I have given detailed example about relationships, how to set relationship between the tables when there are multiple tables, that is one to one, one to many, many to one, and many to many. This particular part I am not explaining much in detail over here. You will please go through the videos which were earlier sent to you, where I have explained all this concept of setting up relations in detail. One to one relation, one to many relation, and many to many relations. So this is all given in the PDF and also explained to you in the previous videos. Just please go through it. The next important part, which is important for us from the point of view of practicals also, is the retrieval of data using the queries and how to give queries. And exactly that is what has been asked to you also in the question paper. So I'm going to demonstrate that there are two different types of languages that we can use, that is the DML language and the DDL language, that is the data definition language and data manipulation language. So we are going to see how to use the queries and the select query, at the update, the delete one, and the insert queries. We are going to see that in detail. Now this is the table that we sometime back created, fabric table. I have added a few records to this particular table. I have intentionally not entered F004 so that I can show you how to insert that particular record using the SQL statement. So in the question paper, I had showed you how to, this is the first question, use SQL commands to insert a following record, F005, kurta, woolen, and 5. So here, let us see how we can do this. So in this particular table, F004 is not there. So instead of 5, we will do 4. So let us see how to use the SQL statement to enter this particular record. Now for that purpose, we are going to go into, as I told you, the DLL and DDL command difference. The DLL commands are data definition language, and the data manipulation is the DML language. So now the insert, delete, update, all this are the data manipulation languages. So inserting we are going to do from the SQL command. So here I'm going to insert it into the table. So I'm going to use the tools SQL option. Now here I'm going to start writing the command, insert into double quotes the fabric, which is the name of the table, open the brackets. What are the field names which we are given? We are given fabric ID, F name, again in double quotes, F fabric ID, double quotes closed, comma, again double quotes open, F name, close the quotes, comma, double quotes again, item, close the quotes, comma, QTY quantity, again close the quotes. Now close the bracket. Now what are the values? So these are the field name, fabric ID, F name, item, and quantity. Now what are the values you are going to give? VALUES values. And now open quotes again. Now values, if they are alphanumeric, that is where, care, character, etc., then it has to be given in single quotes. So single quotes, F004, single quote, comma, again single quote, again woolen, single quotes closed, again single quotes open, shirt, single quotes closed again, and comma, and then The next one, that is number 4, 5, whatever, that is a numeric number, so I need not put it in single quotes. Only alphanumeric text needs to be put in single quotes. Now I close this bracket. So here, this is the insert into double quotes fabric, the column names, that is the field names in double quotes separated by comma, values, and the actual values that you are going to put into the table or into the record, that is going to be in single quotes, and then click on exit. So now I get this particular message, command successfully executed. Now we will close this and go back to the fabric and see that F004 woolen shirt and 9, which I had given in the command, that has successfully got inserted into this particular table. So this is the way we can insert the table record into the table. Similarly, if I want to delete, now here there is a next question which is there over here, to delete a record F003 from the table. So this is the next one which we are going to do. So for again, we go back to our query table. As I told you, inserting, deleting, creating, updating, all this has to be done from the tools menu, SQL statement. So now here we will write down the command, delete from fabric, that is the name of the table, which one, where, what is the this thing, that is the fabric ID. Fabric ID is equal to, in single quotes, F003 in single quotes. So delete from fabric, that is the name of the table, where the fabric ID, that is in double quotes, is equal to single quotes F003, because that is the question we has been asked. So your command successfully executed. Now when you close here, go back to the table, you will see that F003 has been deleted from the table. Next we go on to the next question, which is to display the records. This is a select query. That means you want to display only the fabrics where the quantity is more than 10. So again we go back here to the table. I close this. I come back here. Now any type of queries for, that is the select query, has to be given from the queries option. So click on the queries and create a query in SQL view. Double click on this and here we will write down the query. What is the query? Let us take a simple query first. Select asterisk from fabric. Now for a recap, you know that you need to run the query. You can either press the F5 key or simply click this particular button on the toolbar and click. It will run the query for me and here it displays to me all the records. The next statement which we need to write is, if I want to see only there where the quantity is less than 10. So what is the statement? I'm again going to write the statement here. Select asterisk from fabric. What is the condition? Where QTY, quantity, that is a field name, is less than or greater than, whichever they have told. Let me go back and see. I think it is, let it be any which way, greater than or less than. Here it will show me less than 10. Again, I will run the query and it is going to show me only those where it is less than 10. If I want greater than, I can just go back and say greater than 10. Again, I run the query. It will show me only where the quantity is greater than 10. Similarly, if I want to see only shirts, then what I will do? Where, what is the field name? Item. Item, you can put it in double quotes also. No problem. Where item is equal to single quotes shirt. Why did I put it in single quotes? As I've already mentioned, in any alphanumeric data, that is alphabets and number combination, that has to be put in single quotes. When it is a numeric data, you need not put it in single quotes. Now I will run the, it will show me only shirts. So this way I can give any query depending on the condition, the select query. Now the last question, that is to sort the records in descending order of type. Go back again here. Select from fabric, that will remain the same. Now what is the thing we want to sort it? And what is the command for sorting? Order by. Order space by. Order by what? By F name. F name, that is the fabric name in ascending order. ASC. Now, if I will run the query, it will show me the fabric name in ascending order. C, D, D, L, S, W, W, like this. Suppose if I want to do quantity, ascending order of quantity, how will I write? Again, select from fabric, order by Q, T, Y, quantity in descending order. D, E, S, C, descending. So, ascending is ASC, descending is DESC. Now it will, I will just run the query and it will show me in descending order 30, 22, 20. Like this, it will show me in descending order of quantity. So this way, these were the commands which are there in your, this particular question paper which was there, that is insert into, delete, sorting and displaying the records for a particular quantity. This was the assignment which was given to you in your exam paper, and we have solved this particular question practically in this particular video. And the last session of this particular RDBMS unit is the creation of forms and reports using wizards. So let us just look at that also quickly. We can just double click on the forms option, and forms are easy ways to create do data entry into a particular table. So click on forms and we are going to use the form wizard to create a form. Now here we just have to simply, the table which is selected is already fabric because there is only one table. Then I click on all the fields I need to do, use the all the fields into the form. So I just simply click on this, click on the next option. Now I don't want any subforms, so I just click on the next option. What is the type of arrangement, which is the type, like I want in this particular format or this way format, whichever format I want to. Let's take a simple format like this. Click on the next option. Now, do not allow modification of the existing data. Yes, or if you want, you can use, if I click on this, then whatever the 5 or 10 records I already entered initially, that will not be allowed to change. Do not allow deletion of the existing data and do not allow addition of new data. No, this out of this, I'm not clicking on any of these options. I just simply click on next. What type of backgrounds I want, beige, dark color, orange, whatever I want, I can select that and then click on next. Here, what is the name that I'm going to give to this particular form? So I'll say fabric data entry form. I'm just giving a name to it and then click on finish. Now here, when I click on this, automatically all my previous data which is there, that comes here. You can see over here, this will click the next record 4, 5 and 6. Now if I want to add a new record to this particular table, it comes here and then I can write here, say F010 tab. Suppose the next one is, let's take woolen again. Here again, I'm going to say jacket and quantity, let's take 12. Then again, press enter. It takes you to the next one, F0012, some number I'm giving. Tab, next one is cotton, item, kerchief and quantity 100. So this way, I can add records using this form. I close this. Do you want to save the changes? Yes. Now when I go back, so this is my form, the fabric data entry form. When I double click on the fabric, the new ones which I just now I did, that also comes into the table. So this way I can do quick data entry using my forms. So in forms, I double click, again open, and my data entry form is ready. And the last part, which is creating a report, again using the wizard. I can double click on this, creating of wizard. Similarly, same way I can follow the steps which are there. So here again, fabric table, I select all the fields, click on next. So what are the field labels? If I want to give, I can give different labels also. I can give it in capital, fabric ID, name, item, quantity. I'm just giving it in capital letter. Next, if I don't want any particular grouping, and ascending order of, let's, you want ascending order of fabric name or something like that, you can even select that. Let's take fabric name. Next, whatever type I want, I can see the, you can see at the background the particular type of there. So let's take the bubbles generics here, all with the company logo. If you want, you can do all that, the world map. So let's take the simple one, bubbles. I'm just here. Also, there are a lot of other options. We are not going into much details about it. You can select any one of the formats available. And what do you want to, this thing, detail of fabric. I'm just giving a name to this, detail of fab of let's take detail of stock and click on finish. Now my report is automatically generated over here. Detail of stock, that is the name of the report, and here my entire report is automatically generated. I close this, I come back, my report, detail of stock is ready, my forms, the queries which I had done, and my table is ready. So with this, the entire revision of your particular RDBMS module I have already completed for you. So these are the forms, and the last part, which is creating of reports, that is also done for you. So this particular video was a complete revision of your unit number 3, that is RDBMS unit. When, if you go through this completely, you will be able to get a quick review, a revision of the entire unit that we have done. Please go through it carefully again so that you can understand this unit very thoroughly. Thank you.